Hello, my name is Thomas Telekdi. I'm working with DHI as a global product specialist for Mac Plus, and I'm focusing on water distribution, collection systems, and urban flooding. Today, I want to show you how to add multi-line labels to a map view in Mac Plus. Labels are useful to get access to information without the need of opening an editor. And that's fine and easy in Mac Plus if you want to display only one attribute per element. But if you need to see more than one attribute, I'll show you. This is Mac Plus. I've opened the setup from our free course, Mac Plus Getting Started with Urban Drainage Modeling. So you'll see manholes here and pipes. And I open the notes editor. Because what we want to do is we want to show the ground level and the bottom level for each manhole. You see the two columns here, and the whole workflow relies on user-defined columns. The user-defined columns are, something new to compared to our earlier Mike Urban. I right-click on the line numbering and add a user-defined column. And we have two types of user-defined columns. One which is really written into the database, but the downside of this approach is that I have to update the column every time I change something in the fields here. So instead, I use an expression column. Here's the name. I start with exp to make it visible and clear that this is not a generic Mac Plus field. And here I open the expression editor. And under variables, I find all the fields in my editor. And I need the ground level, first of all, ground level. This is going to be a string, a text field. So I have to convert this, which is not a text, into a text. Here are many functions. And one of the functions is called toString. So it's down here somewhere, toString. And the parentheses, of course, is here. If I hit OK and OK again, it will be at the far right of my grid. I show columns in active tab only. This reduces the grid to the active tab here, and user-defined columns are attached to description. So if I change ground level to 5, you'll see that the expression label is changed to 5 as well. It's very much like in a spreadsheet, back to 4. Yeah, but that's not really yet a multi-line expression. So we will add the bottom level. Now, bringing several strings together is done with a plus sign as a concatenation sign. You have all the operators here. Oops, I only need it once. I simply copy the toString here and from the dropdown, I take the invert level, which is the field name in the database for bottom level. Okay. And we see the two numbers here are visible or printed next to each other. And but that's not really what we want. I could add a simple slash in between. Here we're almost where we want to be. I add a little bit of explanation here. This is the ground level equals, and again, concatenation, and the same here, plus bottom level equals, and the concatenation. Yep. But of course, we don't want a slash, we want a new line. And the code for new line is backslash n. Hello, this is Thomas again. When I was almost finished with this video, I found out that there is a small problem with Mic Plus. When you close the project and open it again, it shows you the expression in the state when you first hit OK. In our case, this was ground level just a couple of minutes ago. So the workaround is simple. Once you are satisfied with your expression, you copy it somewhere. In my case, I copy it into a text editor. Then you delete the column. You create it again. You paste the expression and you hit OK. And as this is the first time we hit OK, this is the state which is saved to the database. I'm sorry for the inconvenience. I hope we'll get that problem out of Mic Plus very soon. You don't see it here, but you'll see it in the map. So I close the nodes and switch here to layers and symbols. To add labels to the nodes, here are my nodes. I single click on default, which opens the symbology settings for colors and symbols. And here is the label tab. And I click on visible. Here are all the attributes in the table. And at the beginning I've said, labeling one field is easy, but let's see what happens if we choose exp label and hit apply to map, which is always important. And switch back to map. And here we are, ground level, bottom level. I change the placement and the size. Let's increase the font size to 13 and the position I prefer lower right. Yeah, and the Y distance is also a bit too large. So let's reduce that to 5. And there we are. You can zoom in, you can zoom out. The labels move around. So I hope this tip will help you to become more efficient. Drop any questions you have in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you next time.